everybody. We're going to be working on some tumblers for you today. Tom is going to be working on a tumbler that he's going to be using some acrylic paints, and he's prepping his cup right now. I'm going to be doing a galaxy tumbler with alcohol inks. I have primed and prepped my cup. It is primed in black matte spray paint, and then I have taken white matte spray paint and spray painted some splotches on the cup. That's where I'm going to apply the alcohol ink to create the galaxy pattern with the alcohol inks. So base black on your cup, and then spray paint white for those alcohol inks to show. So Tom's joining us. He's going to be working on a cup. Did you have to get it? You ready to get it dry?
Yep.
So we're going to be painting a lion tumbler today. Looks way cool. And we're going to see how that works out. So we're going to have some fun. All right. So the first thing I want to do is go over the materials I'm going to be using. Tom's just got an assortment of acrylic paints, brushes, normal painting supplies. Again, I have alcohol inks. I'm going to be using the Ranger Black, Pinata White. Is that going to work? Maybe a more dense color. That's a neon. So I don't know. It's going to take multiple layers. Baja Blue by Pinata. The Passion Purple Pinata and the Magenta by Pinata. I'm also going to use a little bit of the Re-Reese, the Ocean Green, and maybe some Lettuce by Ranger. We'll see on that. I've got a couple of holographic silver glitter I'm going to use for some very light sprinkling of stars. I also am going to be using Black Cat by The Glitter Guy. It is a straight black sparkly glitter. And then I'm also going to be using a black holographic from queenglitz.com. And this one is Black Hollow. And this actually has some color glitter in it. So it's got some pigments of some of the night sky. So this is going to help me resemble some other stars and stuff. So I've also got some makeup sponges. This is what I'm going to be using to apply them. They do tear in half. There's a little mark on there. So I'm just going to be using a sponge for each of my colors. All right. And go ahead and get started. I do have epoxy, so we're going to be doing this cup up with ink, and then we're going to go ahead and get it on for epoxy. I am wearing a glove for alcohol inks. I am a messy crafter, and I will get ink all over my hands. So I'm going to wear gloves in this process. All right. And I'm going to glove the other hand because, you know, I'm going to be touching the sponges with it, so. Purple is one of my favorite colors, so I'm actually going to start with the purple. And I like when there's a lot of purple in the galaxy. To me, it's one of the things that stands out a lot against the other colors. So I'm just going to apply some on my sponge, and then I'm just going to start dabbing it in. Now, you don't have to just work in the areas that you have applied the white base coat. You can actually cover some of the black in it too. It's all going to blend at some point. So you can do that. Don't forget your bottom. And just in my areas that I have put some white spray paint, I'm going to bring in those colors. So. A little bit of ink goes a long way. I also brought up some 91% rubbing alcohol so that I can use that to blend if I need to. So next color I'm going to bring in is probably maybe just a touch of the pink. Let me look. So I tend to shy a little bit on the pink. I don't do a lot of pink in my cups. It tends to overwhelm them, but it's pretty in the galaxy. So we're going to add just a tiny bit. Is it working better? I guess it's picking up. Do some Baja Blue. I'm going to overlap. I'm just going to bring in some more of that purple, which is kind of neat. Just a different shade of it. And again, don't be afraid to go into the black space that you've got spray painted there. And it's just kind of a really light muted green. I grabbed that lettuce because I thought this might need a little bit of brightness added to it. Hey, you're so proud. You're hungry. You didn't eat, did you? Mm-hmm. Oh, should I grab some food? Work, work, work.
Work, 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 work.
Go to work, work. Come home, work. Work, 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 work. All right, I'm going to bring in a little bit of this green to see if I can brighten up that other one. No, that one came out fast. Wasn't expecting that one. Okay, this color is like a weird, it's kind of a weird color. I'm digging it. It's kind of a neat blend in there. Kind of a bright, weird. It's kind of weird. I don't like that. I'm going to go back over it with the alcohol, the teal color, the green color. See if that gives me a little bit more brightness. I don't know if I'm digging this one. I do like it, how it blends though with other colors. It's pretty cool. It almost turns yellow. I didn't expect that. Oh, I need a drink. All right. Let's put some of that green back
in. I'm guessing this is going to take a couple cups.
You think? I mean, it really actually looks like it's coming out. Kind of cool. This color is not doing it for me. I think I'm going to have to reach back in and see what. And it's just picking up the other colors and blending them. It's kind of dulling them, but it's kind of a weird Starbucks. Or Starbursty, Starbucks.
Starbucks.
Apparently want some coffee. I don't know, I kind of like what's in my cup right now. So that one doesn't blend like the other one. Let's look at the other colors we got. It's just not bright enough for me. I want something with a little brightness. crazy. You know what? This pool might work. And that might give me the coverage that I want. Let's try teal. Yeah, we're going to try pool. Let's see if this gives us a little bit more of that blue. I think that. Ah!
Tell me green.
Sorry.
Shaking the table.
I will lift up. Not do this on the table, I'm sorry. I know when you're painting fine lines, sorry. That's really reading me. Sorry, sorry, sorry. Inspiration picture. Do you want to show them that?
No.
No, you're going to just surprise them, huh?
Yeah.
Show them in the end when it's an amazing masterpiece.
I'm basically doing a paint by color. I've got a picture, took a water transfer, put it onto the cup, and I'm painting it like the picture.
Very cool.
Or at least trying to.
I'm working on that. I'm going to leave some of that citrusy green color in there because I kind of like how it's peeking out here and there. I really like that. And I think I might actually get a little bit more in there because I took it away with another color. And then I'll come back in, I think, a little bit more with the blue. I really can't wait to see how yours turns out. I really do like it.
Well, the picture's cool. The paint job is yet to be determined.
Well. And I'm just taking it up a little bit with that green. Ink and go in and blend this up a little bit more. And then we're going to add a little bit of alcohol to a brush to kind of break it up a little bit.
Shake, shake, shake.
I'm sorry. You may have to keep reminding me. And I'm just kind of blending that out and up. Kind of brightening it up a little bit. Because once we go back in with the black, it's going to get dark again. So tints of color. I'm going to pop a little tiny bit of that pink in the bottom. It's missing. It's missing a little bit of pink. Kind of bouncing it over. brightening it up, but blending it with the other color. We're going to actually take a little bit of the separate pink on top of the black. And the reason is because when we put some glitter on, it gives it a little bit different sparkle. Take a brush, dip it in some alcohol, rubbing alcohol, blot it off. I'm just gonna blot it off. I think I need to clean up my brush a little bit. I don't want a lot of alcohol on my brush. I just want a little bit, because what we're gonna do is we're just gonna kind of tap it. And it may not look like anything's happening, but just give it a minute. And as that alcohol starts to react with the ink, it creates, I don't know if you can see that, it creates these little dots that are, I don't know, just kind of breaks it up and gives it a little bit more interest, I guess. And I like to do that in different random places. Because it adds a technique, adds a texture to it. I'm going to keep doing that. Just creating some little groupings. It's just kind of random. Anywhere you need to blend it a little bit, this is a good way to kind of go in and do that. Just run any of those hard lines over with a little bit of the brush. You just don't want it to get too much into a pattern. Like that. And then a little bit more ink on. Let's try a little bit of that. I didn't want it to be such a hard line. It was quite bright. That's not. Sorry, I probably have not. Oops, I just picked up some of that ink. That's kind of neat. Kind of like how that happened. So, we're going to let this dry just for a minute, and then we're actually going to get ready to do some epoxy. We're going to do a very light, tiny bit, just to fill in some of our black with some glitter. We don't want it to move too much, so we're going to kind of epoxy it, let it spin for a little bit, and then once it stops moving, and that we're going to apply some of the glitter so that we can control... how that goes. So I'm actually thinking I'm just going to hit this with a heat gun real quick just to make it dry. Before we do all that, just going to tap in some of the black alcohol ink into those spots that it hasn't quite blended all the way through, but it's kind of flat. So it's just creating a texture on them, you can see. That's what we're doing. Just creating a little bit of texture. Ouch. Dabbing. I keep hitting my knee on that. It's a terrible place for that. Pretty good. Out of the way. And what I'm going to do, I'm going to mix my epoxy up. And it's so hot up here. It's ridiculous. My epoxy, I already have it measured out. I'm just gonna go ahead and pour it and stir it real quick and check in with Tom. How's your Tumbler going?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I don't like the way the acrylic is munching. It's collecting.
Oh. Maybe it's the water slide or
maybe.
Do you think it has anything to do with like the clear coat or anything?
No. It just seems kind of weird. But we'll see.
Okay. So I mixed up my epoxy. I mixed up 20 milliliters for this is a 20 ounce cup. So I did 20 mls of the epoxy. Sorry, I'm probably bumping the table again.
Nope, you're fine. Okay. Definitely should put my hair in a ponytail.
Do we have a band around here?
No.
I don't see one. I thought I had one up here. First thing I'm going to do is get a nice good coat on, and then I'm going to take off epoxy because I want to make sure we have good coverage. But then I'm going to take off a bunch of epoxy because I want it to be just a super, super, super thin coat. Check that out. I love the yellow in there.
I think it's good, but you can see the brush strokes. That's what I don't like about it.
Yeah, but then it looks like it was painted instead of printed.
Yes.
You know what I mean?
I wish it would just be a little smoother.
Galaxy is going to be so pretty. I am totally, at the bottom, totally loving these colors. This is way pretty. Okay. Let's make sure we got everything covered. I'm just working my way around the cup with the epoxy, just making sure that I got full coverage. Let's see if I can slide on the camera a little bit better. You're gonna have hair, paint your hair. You're gonna have all sorts of colors. I love seeing a cup under epoxy. Oh, so pretty. So pretty. All right. So I am going to take off those gloves. I'm going to give this a little bit of heat. And I'm going to bubble it to the surface. Spin for just a second, and then I'm going to torch it so I can get all those little micro bubbles out, and then we're going to let it spin for a few minutes, and then we're going to start to doing some light glitter.
Pretty sure I have turquoise in my hair now.
Which side?
I don't know.
I can try to find you a... Thank you. Way cool. I like the blue. It's gonna be brighter on there. But I do have epoxy left over. I'm probably going to throw it in a mold, but I wanted to make sure that I get some good coverage here first. Pretty, pretty, pretty. Alright, I think what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and I'm gonna stop. I'm going to start with Black Cat. It's my solid black. It's just a black, nothing else sparkly in it. It's just the black. And it does really nice under epoxy. And I'm just going to lightly put this, I'm going to stand up for this part for sure. I'm just going to put it where the black is on the cup still. So I'm just going to sprinkle. I don't want a lot. I just want a little bit to give it a little bit of sparkle. It's okay to go over your colors a little bit with it. So it gives it dimension. It is going to shift and it is going to move, but that's okay. It's okay to have it shift and move on to your colors. And the sky is got all sorts of beautiful wonders in it. With this, I think I got enough on there, don't you think? I think so. Let me check the bottom out. The Black Cat. Let that stand for a little bit longer. Oh wow, check that out. I'm gonna move my cup's big head. Put it up closer so they can see it. Very neat. I like it. I love that lion. Way cool. Alright, now I'm going to add in the Queen Eclipse Black Hollow. And this has got colors in the glitter, so this is going to give it some of that extra star look. And I'm going to just drop a little bit of this over the whole cup. A little bit here. A little heavier in the black area. That's where you're going to see more stars. A little bit of that. I'll let that spin for a second. You can see that. And then the last little bit before we just let this spin to my silver hollow. This is going to be very, very sparingly. So I'm just going to kind of get it way up at. I just want a couple brighter stars. Just a couple. And I don't want to forget the bottom. A little bit heavier in the black spaces. That's it. I'm just going to let that spin until it's dry, and then we will do another coat of epoxy since we've just put glitter down. We'll do another coat of epoxy on it, and then I'll add that towards the end of the video so you guys can see the thing when it's all done. Should we do a to be continued?
A to be continued.
Still working on the lion. Sounds good. Awesome. That's all for tonight, folks. Oh, did I show them a glimpse of that with the little spots? I don't know if I did. See the bigger holographics look a little bit more like stars. Love it. If you guys have any questions, go ahead and leave a comment below on the video. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Check out our Facebook business page, Thirsty Turtle Tumblers on Facebook, or our website, thirstyturtletumblers.com. Have a good night.